Hiya, Mum.
So we're heading into what counts as the Maya Temple's boss stage. There's no actual boss to fight, but we're definitely going to have a fight, so let's quickly go over the basics of combat just to make sure you're ready. So as you'll know, your A button jumps and your B button attacks. Repeatedly smacking the B button will make Quill unleash a flurry of consecutive attacks. Now if you press both of these buttons together at the same time, little Quill will evade, which means she'll do a little dash out of harm's way. But if you do take a hit, try to get Quill over somewhere safe, heal her up and send her back into the fray. Now you have got one more move, which is a drop attack, and you do that by attacking while you're still mid-air. So you can jump and before you hit the ground, you hit attack. It's only really worth doing if you're dropping down on enemies from above though, as it's pretty slow and I don't know if it does more damage. Ooh, and by the way, check this out. Check it out. You can cut the grass. I know that meant nothing to you, Mum, but any Breath of the Wild fans watching this just went mental. Now the basic enemies are like bad boxers and they really do telegraph their attacks, meaning that you can see them coming a mile away. These guys are going to try and get close to you and smack you, and their punch has a really visible wind-up. So while you're attacking, watch out for them swinging a claw back, and as soon as you see them do it, hit both buttons to evade, then continue smacking away. So with the fireball lobbing ones, try to time your approach so that you dash out of the way of a shot and then try and leg it over to them before they fire off another. But the other thing that you can do with these guys, remember, is if you grab them with a blob, you can have them shoot other enemies. In this particular fight though, that's only worth doing if you're not down in the kill box yourself. But really, the main reason to get grabby is if you do grab an enemy, they're out of play until you release it. So you can use this to keep the shooty enemies from littering the fight with hazards while you take out your easier foes. This is also useful to stop them shooting at you if you're trying to get close to them, and also while you're trying to hop along platforms. If push really does come to shove though, you can resort to bully boy tactics. If you grab an enemy, you can effectively hold their arms behind the back, leaving them defenseless while Quill administers a fatal beatdown. Look, it's mean, I know, but you didn't start this thing, damn it. Anyway, bye, Mum.